Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The issue here is that we have to stop the bleeding. We currently cannot sustain the system as it exists. So we currently have a total number of non-disabled 19 to 64-year-old individuals that are on medical assistance is almost 1 million people, almost 1 million we have. And that number of disabled, non-disabled, 19 to 64-year-old individuals that report $0 in income is 495,719 people. That's 51%. 51%. And we've had plenty of exemptions on here. So if you're pregnant, if you're the primary caretaker of an individual who's disabled, there's plenty of exemptions. So we capture. We're talking about able-bodied individuals here, working ages that have exemptions on here. This is reasonable. This is absolutely reasonable, and we need this. Every dollar that we spend on an able-bodied individual is a dollar and resources that we're taking away from our most vulnerable that we're trying to protect here. I've listened to a lot of concerns about the cost savings and how much is this going to cost the taxpayers. Well, the taxpayers can't afford it right now. The budget's growing at 6 to 7% a year. It's not sustainable. We have to be judicial with our resources, and this bill will allow us to start that process. I encourage you all to vote yes on this bill. Thank you.